one particular topic. So under the globe, whatever might be the problem that they can ask in that particular question, in that particular topic, you should be able to answer. The individual should be able to answer. Then only you will be getting the credits. And there will be more than one correct answer, even if it is multiple choice. You are supposed to select all the correct answers, then only you will be getting positive marks, otherwise you will be getting negative marks. So they are also entering into the 4-year graduate program. Probably the institute name is different, that's all. We have our own CET examination. People entering with that particular information, they are going to get it graduated. When they are graduating, the expectation is that they need to leave either with a product or a service, okay, methodology of service that they want to practice in their career. So this is what is expected from any engineer. And now they are claiming that under NEP, it is not only for engineer, it is for any higher education institution, it is applicable. To start with that, first we should all know what is the thesis all about, because I could hear from some of our faculty member, okay, sir, only for major project we can go for publication, for minor projects, we have not done that. Let me put it this way. For minor project, we have not gone up to the publication. Then where about the startup? What is major difference between mini project and minor project, major project? I'll just give you. See, comprehending all the courses that you have learned in your 7 semester or 6 semester duration, you are going to solve a particular problem which requires notions of various subjects that you have learned or that particular individual have learned. That is what major project is all about. Once you are having minor project, more notion is taken from one particular subject. Other than that, there is no difference between major project and minor project. Okay? Even in our days, it was between 1996 to 2000, when I was graduating, we have did 3 mini projects. Probably during that time, the Oracle was very famous. Okay, we have got RDBMS. RDBMS, we did one particular project. Then web app development, with web 1.0, we have did one mini project. And second one, the fourth semester, with your C graphics, you need to do one particular mini project. And most of the time, we need to submit this in the, whereas the project will be given during the even semester of every academic year. So you need to complete and you need to submit it. Only during, when the placement started in the 7th semester, the projects were slightly moved to the earlier semester. That's it. That is the only modification that we have during our days and the current days. During our days, it was something like that. Whereas at the end of 8th semester only, the companies usually they used to come for placements. Then it had moved to 7th semester. Later they started recruiting during the 6th semester itself. Then they will be running their internship during the 7th and 8th semester. So these things came into picture. So don't assume that for mini project you cannot even write a paper. Here they are discussing about converting into a startup. Okay? So before all these things, just I want to give you some input whether we are following this particular requirement or not. Okay? Whether we are following this particular requirement or not. So that we will go with the next one. Okay? So before that, what is the problem-based learning? I want to just give you a small input. See, in each and every course, if you are implementing problem-based learning, it is some minor improvement that you need to do in your pedagogy. If you do that, then definitely even your laboratory experiment, whatever that you are doing now, that also you can publish. Very simple thing. If you are, see, most of our equipments, that too, when we go with electrical and electronics equipment, these are all not industrial standard equipment. Let me be very frank. Okay? In fact, recently I went to one Tech Labs, who is going to give us one particular product, wherein we are just going to convert the exhaust into activated carbon. You are saying, no, there is one exhaust that will be there in each and every two-wheeler. Okay, that we call it as exhaust pipe. Okay, in that exhaust pipe, there will be something called catalytic converter, which will try to filter the carbon which is available. Probably mechanical people will be giving more input. So that particular carbon which is being collected, we want to convert into activated carbon, which you can use it for your water filters. Okay, so this was the thing that we were doing. Okay, the complete process. Okay, how you are going to do it and all those things. So we recently went for the person who is supporting us in creating most of the parts which they used are substandard, not as per the industrial grade. Even when you are using SS, okay, there are various combination of SS that is available. So all those things that they need to use appropriately for getting that to maintain that particular temperature and to work in that particular temperature, all these things it is to be done. Not there. And then they supply the components, they will ask whether it is an industry or academic institution. Academic institution means by default that they will be giving some government. So if the students are doing the experiment, whatever the standard experiments that is there now, if they are writing their own observation, that itself we can publish as one paper. I am giving you writing. You take one particular diode which you have received from one particular industry. Okay? Under various conditions, try to measure its performance. Yes, that is one very good paper you can submit. Then you can recommend using your recommendation system properly. Artificial intelligence people who are learning, there is something called recommendation system. You can recommend whether you can procure this particular diode from this company or not. Okay? So this is as easy as that. But only thing, we are supposed to be exposed to that particular type of culture. Okay? As of now, I have just created a small input how you can, even you can convert your laboratory experiment into a particular paper for publishing. Second thing, the same thing, if you cultivate that mind at one particular point of time, you can give you combination like the invention of GaN, how it has come. Semiconductor wave is with GaN. So some students, they tried with multiple combinations, okay? Then they brought this. Yes, this is used for fast chargers now. Then how this nanotubes came? Nanomaterial came? Yes, it is by the experimentation. Initially they will do everything in the simulation, then they will be creating all the process, then they will pattern the process, finally they will be going for the implementation. So this is how it is. Okay? So from your respective department, please check all the faculties, they have come here or not. If they have not come, then please try to give the input to them by sending the message. If they are having class, let us don't disturb them. Okay? For example, subsequent hour they are having class, okay, they need to prepare, yes, let them do it. Otherwise, you can just leave that. So this is one that you can do it. So the observation part is very, very important. Even the NAC people, they clearly told the observation is to be, they didn't told it is to be improved, okay, it is to be started. Because in many of our laboratories, the observation part, it need yet to get started. So that's how we are going for this particular process. So why they made this thesis to start up? The culture, it should come from each and every individual when they are practicing any engineering concepts. Okay, it could be anything. It could be basic electronics, or it could be artificial intelligence, it could be robotics. It should be there, the culture should be there with them. For that initially, faculty, we need to initially get transformed to that particular level. Okay? Now, the next part, very, very important part. See, we have learned something called course outcomes. Is there anyone who have not learned about course outcomes? Please raise your hand. I think, yes, I am happy. There is something called program outcomes. Yes? Sir, for anyone, the program outcomes is new. Okay, everyone know about the program outcome? Everyone know about program outcome? Yes, there are some people for them, program outcome is new. Okay. It's those members, they joined academic institution, definitely engineering institution recently. See, at the end of, see, assume that I am an engineering graduate, sorry, engineering aspirant. I am joining an engineering college. Now, after 4 years, what are the abilities that the engineering college will imbibe within me? This is what is called program outcomes. When I am going to get graduated learning engineering in any institute, what are the abilities that an individual should possess? And that is given by the international bodies, okay, which we call as International Engineering Alliance, that is called program outcomes. And there are standard 12 program outcomes which has been given, okay, for engineering. For PG, assuming that undergraduate is already got accredited, there are 3 program outcomes that they have given. And similarly for MBA, there are different program outcomes. For hotel management, there are different program outcomes, all those things that are there. So depending upon the program of study, okay, the program outcomes, that is the ability that you are going to imbibe within that particular aspirant, it changes. Okay? So for 1 or 2 members, probably 3 or 4 members who have been with me for quite some time, the next 10 minutes might be repetition. But for others, I'll be guaranteeing you, though we have gone 2 accreditations, for many of us, it might be new only. Because the awareness is not created. For some people who have attended the training program which we have given, for them it might be repetition, that's what I am saying. Now we will be going for that particular process. Before stepping into it, you just imagine what is problem-based learning, whether we can implement that in our regular teaching learning process, so that each and every laboratory record, each and every thesis, even each and every project report can be transformed to the start. Okay? So now we'll go with that. So, problem-based learning. What are the things that I think this is pretty small? I don't think so. Okay, let me go over this particular thing. Okay, I think I wrongly selected the font size or something. Okay, anyway, I'll read it. Or otherwise I will do one particular thing. Just give me a minute. I will just edit this. And I will share it in 2. Probably you might be getting a better visibility. So, problem-based solving, there are certain things that we are supposed to practice, working in teams. See, now in this also, there are individual contribution is very, very important. And there are some solutions which can be given as an individual, that is also currently it is being practiced in the industry. So, working in teams as well as the PBL, when it was started somewhere in 2010, vigorously in some of the universities. So they've gone with this particular thing, working in teams, managing project and holding leadership role. Okay, as a team, if you are having, each and every individual will be acting as an individual commando, and they will be leading the particular team, and in fact they will be having their own contribution towards a warrior and recruit communication. Then self-awareness and evaluation of the group process, working independently. So these are all a subset of attributes that we are required or that is expected in your problem-based learning. Then the next one, we have critical thinking and analysis, explaining the concept, self-directed learning, applying course content in the real-world examples, researching and information literacy. Then the last one, problem solving across discipline. Okay, now anyway, I will come back to this particular part again. Now we have practiced this program outcome. So once you are implementing your problem based learning in your class, each and every class towards it is progressive. Okay, at the end of 50 sessions, definitely the group of team members who are having learning engineering practice with you, they will be having one particular product. See, it might be simple or complex, it is immaterial, but they would have learned all the concepts that are available in your course and they will be having the product. So this, I want to make it very clear. Now, let us go with our program outcomes. Now, we have seen certain things which is called problem-based learning. And you can just check when you refer the probably first or second reference that you will be getting, this list only you will be getting it. Okay, it might be MIT or it might be Illinois University, it might be Hum University. They will be having this particular practice, problem-based learning. And many people, as I told, they started in early 2010. Okay, now we are discussing this particular part because 3 years back, during that time, S12, the Ministry of Education has called us, Ministry of Human Resources and Development, they told that each and every PhD thesis should convert to become a startup. But they probably getting some more users that PhD thesis is being sold. Okay, that is a different scenario. Don't go with the exceptions. Okay, think about those things which are positive. Okay. Because I used to get this particular input, so you are saying talking too much about the product and other things. But I could see some of the people, they are getting PhD report in some shops for 50,000 rupees, 60,000 rupees, and it is also, they have been also awarded. Why you are going for those exceptional cases? Okay, come for the other way where the 80% they are doing the actual work and it has been published in good publication and they are coming out with the particular product. This is what it is. See, I also multiple times I shared with many people, okay? Though our research got published in some of those things, but still now, okay, the number of people using that particular concept is very, very less. Sometimes it do happen. Say, especially when you consider about the CDMA, okay, is one particular technology, code division, multiple access is one particular technology. Now it is available in almost many devices, many networking devices. But until 25 years, okay, till the patent was available with that individual, no one used it. So it might be the case because everyone knows about electrical vehicle, okay? Because when it was the fossil vehicle was invented, that during the time itself we got electrical vehicle. Until the platform is set across the world for electrical charging, it is difficult for them to roll out because it is a business involved. So when they want to do the business, the initial infrastructure should be available and it has to be established. And we are relying to do the manufacturing for our own needs, okay? How we can give the extra energy, if the energy is excessively produced, then only we can supply it for the vehicles. If it is not satisfied for even domestic and industrial purpose, then how we can give it for the other things? Now, because of the renewable energy and solar energy and many things it has been evolved and we are able to get provide solution, electric vehicles have started manufacturing. So you need to wait until the right time when it is going to click, it will be started using. Similarly, that you have faced the Paytm. When it was introduced, you might have think, who is going to scan and pay the amount? Now everyone is doing. Each and every vendor is using. So you need to wait for your turn until your work is completely accepted by the society and they are using it. The patent is only main thing that you need to do it. Okay, you need to wait for it. And say yes. Similarly, the printed thing, but I forgot his name. Okay, the first time I think it's a Dutch artist. Okay, who had first time the print type of product it has been, he only made it. But throughout his lifetime, he was able to sell only one particular print. After that, yes. After his death, actually he suicide himself for some reasons. Okay. Then he got his technology was used everywhere. Now whatever that you are having, including the 3D printing, yes, it is because of his invention during his period in 18th century. So that's how it goes. You need to wait for some time. Okay. So there are certain things that we want to have. Now we'll just go over something, the relation between the problem-based learning and we have seen certain things. In simple terms, simple vocabulary it has been given. What are the things that are available? Now we go with the program outcomes of our accreditation process. Whether it is a NAC or MBA, we have something called program outcome. Even when we are going for ABET accreditation, you have something called student outcome. These are things that are required. Just you try to relate. Now you have got, I'll just scroll through this one more time. Working in teams, managing projects and holding leadership role. Work-learn written communication, self-awareness and evaluation of group processes, working independently, critical thinking and analysis, explaining the concept, self-directed learning, applying course content to the real-world examples, researching and information literacy, problem-solving across discipline. That is, it is, they are saying that interdiscipline. And these things they have written in 2010. Okay? Those universities who have started practicing this problem learning. Now, let's go to the program outcomes. So, we are just taking the engineering, undergraduate engineering. Just relate this problem-based learning, which will lead to development of a product. So, what does it mean by a startup and an enterprise that I will say? See, if you are able to create a particular product, okay? The startup tenure ends. After that, Monday to Friday, you are going to repeat that particular same process continuously. Then you are starting an enterprise. Okay? That is Monday to Friday, you are going to repeat a sequence of process. See, from Monday to Friday, what we are doing, morning we are coming and we are handling the lectures and we are imparting knowledge to the students. So this is an iterative process. So this is also one enterprise which is doing the regular activities. So similarly, once the startup have reached to one particular state where your product is ready, then you are landing into an enterprise, you are transforming yourself to an enterprise where every day you are going to manufacture that particular process during the various stages, it will be reaching and it will be going better. So this is what the difference between your startup and enterprise. Okay? So once here they are not asking to become your as an enterprise. They are asking to transform yourself, the pieces to your startup. So you need to land in only the product. So better have the clarity in all these terminologies. Don't confuse with all these things, startup, enterprise, okay. All these things don't confuse. Better be very simple and learn the particular concept very easily, okay. Now, let us go to the program outcomes, okay. I'm just going for a navigation screen, which will take me to one particular presentation. Okay, that particular presentation will be available. Probably some people would have already gone through that particular presentation. Okay, so I am directly landing into my required content. Probably many of you would have completed your course outcome and program outcome mapping by learning this. First we will be reading the content of your program outcome and we will be learning, we would have defined our course outcome, we would have mapped this is strongly correlated, moderately correlated, and weakly correlated. Like that, you would have got certain things. Okay? See, if you are being given enough input or the awareness to the maximum extent, to the core, if it is being given it to you, your pedagogy would have changed in a different way. And you will not feel the pain of handling even 6-hour session or 7-hour session or 8-hour session. Okay? And second thing, your confidence level will be a bit higher in handling any course. It might be even new course which has been allocated. If you are allotted the proper pedagogy technique where the PBL is being included in your one of the aspects of your pedagogy, then it goes like this. Okay, now we will go with each and every program outcome, and you relate this particular component with your problem-based learning. Generally, we are mapping now. Everyone, we are mapping course outcome with program outcome. Okay? Then at the end of this particular discussion, you will all accept whatever that is expected by our accreditation body is PBL only. And this is not applicable only for mini project or thesis. Every course, okay, you will be able to, or the learner will be able to create a product, or they can publish a patent, or they can publish a paper. Not required only if they do the project, then only they will be able to submit a paper or a product. Try to understand certain things. The way in which that we impart knowledge, it should be changed. This is what is expected. Okay? Now, the first one, apply the knowledge of mathematics, science, engineering fundamentals and an engineering specialization to solution of complex engineering problems. That's what they said. So they clearly told in that simple statement. Apply the concept for real world examples. Yes, they told it. The same thing here. And it might be distributed in different terms. Analysis will be there. They told about that analysis. They told about communication. They told about individual and teamwork. They told about sustainability. Everything is there here also. Then, if we are saying that we are mapping our course outcomes with your program outcome, are we not following problem-based learning? See, what had happened? Let us all accept, which includes me also. We have presented some contents in the paper. This is how my CO is mapping with my PO. We have not practiced. That is why many of institutions, they are getting only 3 years accreditation. Even those people who have got yesteryear, okay, 6-year accreditation, in the subsequent iteration, they got only 3 years. The benchmark institutions also, they got only 3 years accreditation because we are not practicing paper, we are showing that as if, see, in a few publications that we are getting now, the results, okay, we have got this particular results, like that we have started presenting in paper. Once we say that our teaching learning methodology will transform the children, okay, to be an entrepreneur, then you can claim that whatever that you have presented in your paper is exactly what is required. Then there are certain things, sir. Some of the students, they are going for higher studies. How many percentage that they are going for? Across India, if you take, okay, probably less than, those people are graduating, less than 2% take, because that's how the visa status it says. Remaining all are either landing in their business or they are supporting other business as an employee. This is what it is happening. Think in those aspects. Since we have not thought those things in that aspects, we have lost. Why students are not interested in coming to engineering or the other courses? regulated forces, because we have not created any excitement when it comes to learning. See, there are some children, even post the college hours, they are interested in coming for tuitions or some other thing, because some excitement is there in that particular process. Have you created in your inner class? If you would have created, then definitely it will be an interesting. Even if other colleges that they are not getting admission, you will be getting the admission. That excitement should be there. So when you are doing that, I will assure you, I will give you in writing. Okay? You cannot complete your syllabus. I will give you in writing. In your lecture, if you are trying to implement the process, 100% syllabus completion, it is difficult. If you are saying I have completed 100% syllabus, yes, we have followed teacher-centric model, not learner-centric model. That also you need to be very clear in this particular process. So, I think this is not navigated. I will go here and I will show you that particular screen. Is it visible for you? So this is what I told, apply the knowledge of mathematics, science, engineering fundamentals and engineering specialization to the solution of complex engineering problem. The next one, problem analysis, identify, formulate research literature and analyze the complex engineering problem. Researching substantiated conclusion using the first principle of mathematics, natural science and engineering sciences. Okay, so when you are mapping this, you can just see, you need to do the analysis and then you need to come to substantiated conclusion. Why it has happened? What is the reason behind this? Is there any physics which is involved? Is there any chemistry which is involved? Or what is the mathematical relation that you have? All these things the students should learn during our lecture process. Then only we can say, yes, we are able to map this particular course outcome. And can we teach everything? Now, this is what learning space. You need to say, so this is what is happening. Open your browser, check why it is happening, what is the root cause for this particular thing. As we are learning in design thinking, what is the root cause analysis for this? Then, say, once they learn in your class something like whatever that we are discussing, okay? They need not prepare for their in-semester examination. It will be permanently registered in their memory. So this is the concept which will be coming. This is the root cause. He or she had learned and it will be stored in their memory permanently. After that, for English articulation, simple communication is required that anyone can do it. So this is with your problem analysis. There also we got something called problem analysis. There also we got some problem analysis. Then, design and development of solution. Okay? They need to design solutions and in this also they need to consider the safety, cultural, societal and environment consideration. See, in our NAC, they clearly said, okay, related to local relevance problem, nothing we have solved. Is that we are doing something related to artificial intelligence? Is it helpful for the global society? Then why we are building the university here? To support them, to improve their living style, okay? To make their well-being protected. All those things only we are establishing the university. When it is not happening, then what is the use of it? Okay? Yeah, but yes, you are called back. Conductor of investigation. Okay? So there also we had analysis, investigation, real-time examples all those things were there. Then probably usage of modern tools that they have given here. Okay, there when you are going with the providing solution, definitely you will be requiring some tools to be used. Okay, so you can go with that. Then engineering, society and safety. Okay, there also they were giving related to this. Okay, then environment and sustainability, ethics, when you are having the team and other things, how you are following the ethics. Then individual and teamwork, communication, project management, finance and lifelong learning. These are the things that you have practiced for your outcome attainment, and we are saying that my course is contributing to these particular program outcomes. Once you say that, then you are into problem based learning. But only thing, since the awareness is not created, we are following the same lecturing system. My part, I need to complete the syllabus, Whether it is transformed to a product or project, it is immaterial. Okay? Now we are creating the initial, let's say, over 1 day of 1 hour information, your pedagogy will not change. We know that. Second thing, the creating excitement. I thought today I will be creating some excitement, but you are discussing a post lunch, sir. Checking AC is not working, sir. And we need to use our own fans to chill ourselves, sir. We are from Bangalore, you might be from, there is a different place. For you, you are wearing this waist coat and all. Okay, for you it might not be a problem, but wearing a waist coat for Bangalore means it is difficult, sir, in this summer. All these problems are there within your mind. Okay, so if it, in spite of all these things, try to create some excitement, that's what we are trying. Okay, so for this, at least if 60% transformation it is there, then probably we are in the success path. That's what we want to have. Okay, then I'll go back to the presentation. Here you can just see working with team. Okay, the teamwork and the individual leadership that was there. Then managing project, and finance was there. Then oral and written communication, was there. Then self-awareness and evaluation of group. Okay, analysis. Okay, conduction of investigation. All those things were there. Then working independently was there. Critical thinking and analysis in multiple parameters. This has been there. Explaining the concept. That is, again, this comes under your communication. Lifelong learning, you have self-directed learning. Applying course content to the real world examples. Okay, how you are going to use it. Even the first parameter was there, fifth parameter was there. Then you have got researching and information literacy, that is there. Problem solving across all the discipline. Okay, that is also, it was there. So once, see, you need to understand program outcomes which have been designed. It is not designed by one individual or one entity. All the participating countries sat together and they have designed this. There are all the members of the International Engineering Alliance. Okay, they have decided this particular outcomes. So once you are saying that the learner-centric model, you have your course outcome defined. These course outcomes should map with this program outcome. That also if you say, then your course contents, whatever that you have created, and the pedagogy technique that you have created, that will lead to, whether it be a theory course or it may be a practical course, it will lead to a product. Once you say it is leading to a product, who is going to manage that particular product? This is startup. Sir, startup. So this is what we want to give it here. Now, the next thing, I will complete the subsequent process with only one program outcome. Okay. Still, many of us, we have not learned the root of the first program outcome. Then there are 12 program outcomes. For each and everything, we need to learn the root. Okay? probably, again I told you, for some people it might be repetition. Those people who are being there in our training program, that we went to Calcutta University, we went to many universities, for those people it might be a repetition. For other people, to be frank with you, for you it is a new only. It is a new concept for you. Okay? How many people have digged your program outcome to the root level analysis? And we are learning something called Bloom's taxonomy, knowledge level under cognitive domain. Is there anything similar to that is available? Okay? That whether we have learned or not. If it is so, why we are not using that? If we are going to use this, then what is the advantage that you will be getting? All those things. Within 10 to 15 minutes, I am going to complete that particular process. Okay? So, definitely, I hope so. This will be creating some excitement within you. Yes, I am going to learn at least one program outcome clearly, which it is supposed to be. I'll just navigate the presentation. So here you can just see I have taken the first program outcome. Apply the knowledge of mathematics, science, engineering, fundamentals and engineering specialization to the solution of complex engineering problem is one particular thing that has been given. Okay. So here you can just see there are two keywords for which I need to know the meaning of it. What it actually says there. Okay. So if you go with the dictionary meaning, it will be giving so many meanings. So you can just browse it in your using your mobile phone or any other devices that you are having. The second one, what are the characteristics of complex engineering problem that they are saying? Because when you say complex engineering problem that graduate need to solve, then I should know what is the characteristics of it. Whether we have learned really the characteristics of complex engineering problem. If we generally ask many people, they say complex engineering problem is multiple problem or the solutions of one particular problem which is divided into multiple small pieces or sub problems and which it is providing the solution and we are integrating the final result, then it is called complex engineering problem. Now we are going to learn the real meaning as per the accreditation body, what is the meaning of complex engineering problem. That's what we are going to learn. Second thing we are going to learn, what is meant by the apply keyword with respect to the accreditation body. So for that what we have read, I have just given the hyperlink which will navigate to International Engineering Alliance document. Okay? What it says related to apply. See, for each and everything, there is something called glossary of terms. Even when you are preparing our PhD thesis, you would have prepared something called glossary of terms. With respect to your thesis, what is the definition of each and every term that you have used there? So that is mean by the glossary of terms. So that we have it here. So when you are saying that particular, there is something called glossary of terms, and here you can just see, I'll just copy this and paste it in a notepad. International Engineering Agreement, okay, International Engineering Alliance Agreement, then you will be having that particular part asset and you will be having the uploads and you will be having multiple versions. So we are going for the recent version, version 2, 15 September 2011, which has been given. I'll just zoom it for better visibility. Okay, that is the document that we are verifying now. And when you go browse through it, it will be saying that information that will be given. Apply, carrying out using a procedure in a given situation, executing or implementing. And they are given something called Anderson-Cockrell form. Okay, who is Anderson-Cockrell? Those people who have given Bloom's taxonomy version 2, which we are using in our day-to-day activities. We are saying Bloom's taxonomy version 2. Okay? Or revised Bloom's taxonomy, RBT. Okay? The revised Bloom's taxonomy was not given by the Benjamin Bloom, it was given by Anderson-Cockrell. So our parent document is using Bloom's taxonomy. So we are also using Bloom's taxonomy. In fact, in the parent document, they have used another knowledge level also. That we are going to learn something called Washington Accord knowledge level. That will be learned in short while. That is within few months that we will be learning. So, what is the meaning of apply that we have learned? Now we need to learn what will be complex engineering problem. Okay? What are the characteristics of complex engineering problem? See, post this, you just assess yourself. Even don't show your expression, facial expression to any of your neighbors also. How many people have really assessed the children with the expected knowledge level. Say we have taken only the first program outcome. We have taken only the first program outcome. We are saying that no, sir, you have got accredited. My program got accredited. Twice it has got accredited. Okay? You just refer how many of us actually assess the students as per the expectation. As per the expectation. Then you can claim, yes, we are proud to be an accredited program. Okay? See, there is no harm in it. Accept the truth. Unless awareness is being created, it will be difficult for us to practice certain things. So we are creating the awareness. Okay? Just saying that PhD thesis and the MTech thesis to be startup, that is converted into startup, it is not a thing. We need to create awareness within the faculty member, and then we need to impact the abilities within the students. So this is what you call it, the training model, whatever that you are saying, that is what we are doing it now. Okay? Now, similarly, when you go for the complex engineering problem, okay, I'll just navigate to that complex engineering problem in the same document. What is that it clearly says? So here they say, a class of problem with characteristics defined in section 4.1 of IEA Graduate Attributes and Professional Competencies, version 2. Okay, actually we are now in version 3. This is to be updated. We are having version 3 competency, graduate attribute competencies. So we need to go there. So as of now, we have not got the correct information for learning what is the characteristics or what are the characteristics of complex engineering problem. Further, you need to dig the particular whatever that you say information. Okay. Further, you need to dig the particular internet and get the information. That's how it has to be. Okay. So we will go there. I'll just navigate to that particular part. Okay. So I just click this particular thing, so it will take me to that particular document, which is again from International Engineering Alliance. So we have International Engineering Alliance glossary of terms. Okay, this is again open. Okay, I don't want to open this. This is what I want. International Engineering Alliance Graduate Attribute and Professional Competencies, version 3. Okay, this was given in 2013. I will just zoom it for better visibility. Go to page number 7. There you will be getting 4.1. Whatever that they told us to go. So here you can just see. Range of problem solving with respect to attributes, depth of knowledge required, range of conflicting requirement, depth of analysis required, familiarity of issues, like that we have various attributes. For each and every attribute, the complex engineering problem have the characteristics of WP1 and some are all of WP2 to WP7. Are you able to read the contents from your side? Last. Visibility there, sir? Okay. Sir, once the system is not used for more than 7 minutes, it will be going to the sleep mode, sir. So, okay, because I have taken nearly for 50 minutes, sir. We could have gone 7 minutes for sleep mode, then 43 minutes it is in sleep mode only. And fortunately, for my systems, I have not shown the sleep mode at all. I'll always keep never sleep. Okay? But we can set for this for, but for human being it is difficult, you know, to post lunch session. Okay? So now, here there's a certain things. Okay? Complex engineering problem have characteristics WP1 and are all of WP2 to WP7. So first thing is that WP1 is mandatory. If you are having a complex engineering problem, it is mandatory it should have this particular characteristics, that is WP1. Sir, what is this WP1? Washington Accord Problem Characteristics 1, that is the, what is the abbreviation that we are having here, Washington Accord Problem Characteristics 1. That means there is multiple accords. So in that, engineering graduates should should follow Washington Accord. Okay? So then what is for the diploma students, what is for IIT students? We will learn all those things later. First we will learn engineering, then we will go with the other things. Once you become the master trainer, okay, then during that time we will teach you for the other records. Okay? So here you can just see the given. Cannot be resolved without in-depth engineering knowledge at the level 1 or more. Cannot resolve without in-depth engineering knowledge at the level 1 or more. WK3, WK4, WK5, WK6 or WK8, which allows fundamental base first principle analytical approach. So now only you told something about WP1. It is called Washington Accord Problem Characteristics 1. What is this WK3? The document is not properly prepared, sir. Before any abbreviation, it should be expanded now. Okay? So, WKA is Washington Accord Knowledge Level 1, Washington Accord Knowledge Level 2, Washington Accord Knowledge Level 3. So, where these things are explained, sir. Fortunately, we need not further dip. In the same document, if you scroll down, okay, that particular characteristics, knowledge levels, it has been given. You can just see, here Washington Accord Programs provides WK1, that is Washington Accord Knowledge Level 1, a systematic theory-based understanding of natural science applicable to the discipline. So, is there anything related to remember it has been given here? Because in your Bloom's taxonomy, you have the first one. What is it? Remember. That itself they removed in the Washington Accord Knowledge Level. So then where it is required? It is not required to assess that remember level itself in your engineering program. If the student is able to apply the concept, then it is implicit that he or she has attained that knowledge level 1 and 2. That is why they removed that particular concept in Washington Accord Knowledge Level. Remember level itself, it is not there. Okay? So, what is that we are practicing? If your question paper, if you are having level 1 question, then what it means? You understand. Have we nurtured the children as per the expectation of International Engineering Alliance? You just try to assess yourself. Okay? So if we just evaluate, re-evaluate, moderation to him to Karata. I guess you guys are always, he will be disturbing us. Sir, the moderator, one, the minimum. Moderate, buddy. You will be sending. I think here a good number of moderators are there, no? Is there anyone, the senior level moderator, level not much colleague, sir? Next time, probably. Because subject proficiency matrix, he will take it. So, subject proficiency, you will expert, okay? Give him as a moderator. Or moderator, but fortunately, 90% moderation on mele, there is no change in the question paper. 90%, 10% is there. Why that 90% is not there? Because we are not aware whether the knowledge level and questions are matching or not. Okay? If you are expecting one particular answer, where the concept is already available in the textbook, but he or she is permitted to write in his own statements, then you are assessing something in knowledge level 2. If the standard methodology of problem solving is already available in the textbook, then you are changing only the numericals, asking the student to solve the problem, again it is knowledge level 2. If you are giving a new constraint, where you are expecting more than one solution, then only you are assessing knowledge level 3. Okay? Ega, you moderate maadiro question paper alla etti nodidindre nimge gothagutte, you will know what are the improvements that we are supposed to do in this moderation. I have seen many question paper post moderated. Because it get published now. He will be taking multiple copies and it will be going to the student in MS Teams. You can access it and you can see. More than 70% those people who have given knowledge level 3, knowledge level 4. That is not actually knowledge level 3, not knowledge level 4. Then, sir, there is a keyword called differentiate that is set in knowledge level 4. And similarly, there is a differentiate keyword that is available in knowledge level 2 also, sir. It is again confusing, sir, very immediately. If you are expecting the candidate to write whatever that is available in textbook, then it is knowledge level 2. If you want the student to give his own inferences, then it is knowledge level 4. This is what the difference between that. We need to understand first the knowledge level, then only we need to move the students to one particular milestone to next particular. If we ourselves is not clear with that, then you will be having it. Okay? So, once one student is able to answer all your questions based on the actual requirement of the NBA, he is really writing one particular thesis report. So 44 pages, sir, if he is writing, okay? Generally the thesis report will be for 100 pages. They will be giving that, not more than 100 pages, it should be there. If it is going, then they will be asking to cut off that particular thing, okay? So, if it is more than that, nearly 44 pages, for example, 44 pages or 41 pages, maximum number of booklet, number of pages that they have been given now. So, he or she is writing one thesis report. Of his or her understanding, what is that you need to assess? Is the one whatever already available in the book? Are we nurturing photocopier machines? No, no. So you think in that particular aspect. So we all would have been nurtured in that particular way. Now we need to change it. We need to change it. Now here we are seeing a systematic theory based. Now in the lab today, they have said it should be starting from WK3. The first WP1, Washington Accord Problem Characteristics 1 alone, systematic theory based formulation of engineering fundamentals required in engineering discipline. So, problem formulation first they should know it. Initially, they should be able to give solution for well defined problems, then they should have the ability to form their own problems because they need to see the real time scenario. This is where the scenario is happening. What is the problem definition that I can create for it and how we can provide solution? If you have formed your problem, well-defined problem, that is one fantastic task. Okay, post-exercise solution is becoming very, very easy. Problem identification is one of the toughest job. Okay, that is the one that we have. The next one, engineering specialist knowledge, that provides theoretical framework and bodies of knowledge for accepted practice area in the engineering discipline, much is at the forefront of the discipline. Okay, so what is the trending solution? I have one particular good old solution which I used in grandmother period, grandmother era, that you should not use it. That is what the modern tool usage and modern solutions that are available which you need to go for. Okay? Still, if you ask what is the pedagogy technique that you are adopting, people see, still they used to say, sir, chalk and talk. Have you seen? And blackboard. We are not able to differentiate between our pedagogy technique as well as the teaching aids. These are all teaching aids. Chalk, blackboard, chalk, all these things are teaching aids. Okay? So, now we have given some initial input. How to transform your pedagogy technique so that your every lecture hour will navigate or will move the student from one particular level to next particular level so that they will be developing the product either a team or as an individual in course of 50 hour session whatever that you are having. If you are really doing that, then we can claim that yes, we are accredited institution. You need not prepare your document. The student's reflection will give you accreditation without applying. Now we are preparing and we are submitting so many documents. No, those things are not required. It will automatically come. That has happened in one particular institute in deep south. Okay, they have not applied for the ranking, but the ranking institute, they themselves came forward and they ranked that particular institution during the analysis based on the outcomes that they faced in the industry and society. And that chancellor, the vice chancellor told, we don't want to go behind accreditation. We are doing our accrediting process as per the requirement. Those accreditation bodies are behind us to give the accreditation. This is what we want here. And this does not happen anywhere. It is same in South India. Deep South, that happened. Anyone can guess that particular institute name? Probably you would have also read in the media. Multiple times it pops. Okay, let me give you as an assignment. You can do it if you want to learn. You can learn. Otherwise, personally, ping me, I will just give you the answer. Okay, this is for today's session. Thank you from my side. And even in this also, I have not discussed the first program outcome in detail. I have given half cooked content, something like half boiled. Okay, the remaining, you cook it by yourself. In subsequent iteration, I will be asking questions. That time, I will definitely ask questions. For example, Srinivas, please get up. Okay? Not now, but during that time. So, he is not in sleep mode. Because if someone is in sleep mode, if we call them, it will be an embarrassing situation. The neighbor should make them. And now we are maintaining the social distancing also. It is difficult to do. Okay? So, that is why I am not disturbing those people who are in sleep mode. That's okay?